Marvel Legends, Marvel Animation, Disney Plus, Season 1 of X-Men 97, reintroducing Kurt Wagner, a.k.a. Nightcrawler. What role will he play? Let's get it. What is good, my peeps? It's The Ruckus back at you again with another action figure review. This time, we're bringing up the rear to our series of reviews featuring characters from X-Men 97, the first season of the new series that will be shown on Disney Plus via Marvel Animation. It says Marvel Studios up there. That's because these figures were produced before Marvel / Disney decided to change their name from Studios to Animation. That really, you know, be that as it may, it is what it is. All we care about are the figures, are the characters that we receive. And in this case, we have Nightcrawler, who made appearances in the 90s cartoon. It was never really a member. What will happen this go around in the series in this first season? Only time will tell, and time is growing short. And that's a good thing. Anyway, you see what we got there in packaging on the blister. We've got the figure, the accessories. You see an additional head sculpt and an additional pair of hands. We've got the cell of Nightcrawler there on our left, the logo and animation of the X-Men above. Turning around to the rear, we have a digital render of the figure, and of course all six figures in this wave. And so here we've got Kurt Wagner, aka Nightcrawler, on our stand, giving us a 360 degree rotational view of the figure. And well, anybody that knows Nightcrawler, you already know what it is. This is basically classic Nightcrawler for the most part. He's had a few different costumes in the comics, but he always seems to come back to this right here, which is how we know him best. Currently, he's playing the role of a Spider-Man, believe it or not, if you haven't been following. And that's all part of the Fall of X storyline that has been going on, where the X-Men in the comics I'm speaking of, they've taken a huge L, and they're trying to, I'd like to say, bounce back, but you've got to crawl before you can walk, before you can run, and before you can bounce. So they're right now in the crawling stages. But that's the comics. We're talking about the action figure and the animated show, which is going to begin very soon. Very soon. I am here for it. I'm looking forward to it. What are you guys? Are you looking forward to it? Let me know in the comments below. What do you think about X-Men 97? From what I gather, it's going to resume. It's not a reboot. It's going to resume literally the next day after the last episode of the final season. So that's really going to be interesting to see how that unfolds when the time comes. Anyway, enough about that. We need to see what we got going on here with Kurt Wagner. Now that we've got Kurt off the base, we can take a better look at him. Obviously, as always, we kick it off checking out the face sculpt. And as you can see, we've got the cartoony look going on in comparison with the last iteration that we got of Nightcrawler. We have gotten a mainstream Nightcrawler, a comic-based Nightcrawler, I should say. We will compare in a little bit, but for right now, we see what we got going on. The forehead is got black paint. You know, the head itself is molded in blue, and the hair, you see what we got going on, is black, but it's got blue highlights going on in there. So that's cool that we got that. Hasbro could have cheaped out, but it probably would have affected the aesthetic of Nightcrawler. We've got that black on the forehead to try to give like the simulation, the appearance of him being in the shadows, and you see his eyes pupilless, and he got the black around the eyes, and you know, pretty nice head sculpt. Looking at him from the side, we've got those pointed ears. He, when he made his first appearance, he was being chased by villagers, and because they mistook him for a demon. I mean, he does have that he does have that appearance. Can't front about that. So he got rescued at the last minute by Professor Xavier, who mentally froze the villagers because they had rained down on him, and they had him six ways to Sunday, but he was spared, and that's how he joined the X-Men. That was in Giant Size X-Men 1, way back in the day, 90, I want to say, I say 90, it was before then, I want to say like 80, 70, 76, I think that was the year, 75 or 76. I could be wrong on that year. Anybody that knows, correct me in the comments below, but it was a while ago. Nightcrawler's been around for a minute. The rest of them, you see, basically the body's molded in black. We've got the red, which is a separate piece, like an overlay of sorts. You see where it connects to the lower portion of the torso. The lower portion of the torso is painted. So there is that. If you were to look very, very carefully, you could see that they are two different shades. Not off by much, but they are two different shades. The same thing for the crotch area, painted, molded in black, painted red, right down the middle. Arms, as you could see, losing focus there. Let's correct that if we can. There we go. In black, and then the arms, the forearms. I believe this is the first time we've got that. This is what's new. So this is an animated version of his gauntlets, because if I'm not mistaken, the comic-based Nightcrawler does not have these red accoutrements, if you will, at the ends of his gloves. Got the same thing on both sides, going up in black, as you could see, and going down. Got red on his, I don't know if these are supposed to be socks or boots or anything. All I know is that they're form-fitting to his feet. So we got that, and that's all in white. And then, of course, we've got the tail. We've got the tail. So that is... That is how our guy, Nightcrawler, basically looks like. As far as his articulation is concerned, we've seen Nightcrawler before. They've essentially just repeated. We've got some new parts here, like the arms and the legs. But essentially, it's the same buck. And, of course, we've got different head sculpts. But his head goes back that far, which is great. It's on a ball hinge. Goes down way far. Very cool. Get a little bit of tilt, and of course you can 360 it. You can get a better than 90 degree T-pose going on. And of course you get the rotation 360. He has butterfly joints, so he can rear back very well. As far as the almost hand clap, not so much. Only get that much there. Bicep swivel. Double jointed pinless elbows. He does have swiveling wrists that hinge horizontally. He's got an ab crunch, which goes forward very nicely and goes back very nicely. Back breaking right there. He's got waist rotation. He can spread his hips that far out. He can kick. 90. He get you 90 and go back a decent amount for going back. He's got the thigh cut. He's got double jointed pinless knees. No boot cuff, but he does give you pointing his toe forward that far, up that far. He's got ample ankle pivot. And before I do holes, peg holes at the bottom of the feet, I got to show the tail. It doesn't have bendy wire, but it does swivel around rotation wise. And then, of course, holes, peg holes at the bottom of his feet. I went and brought out a treat for everyone. I've got on our left the original Toy Biz Nightcrawler. And I could tell you about him on our left there. He did come with a bendy wire tail and finger and toe articulation. But, I mean, he looks very, very wonky in terms of the anatomy. Toy Biz used to really, they were tripping when it came to human or humanoid anatomy. Like, for example, look at the size of those feet, you know. But they did have articulated toes. So, you know, it is what it is, or it was what it was. Get him a little bit closer there. And on our right is the Hasbro Nightcrawler that our current X-Men 97 Nightcrawler is based on. Same overall body with differences, i.e. the arms and the legs, and of course the head sculpts. You see the head sculpt that my original Hasbro Nightcrawler has. It doesn't have the darkened facial highlights to make it appear like he's in shadow. He did come with head sculpts that had, I believe, two additional ones. One with angry face, he looked more demonic. So he did come with those black highlights to make it seem like, you know, he was silhouetted. So we do have that. And he came with two additional sets of hands. He came with a sword. I was trying to think of what type of sword he had. A cutlass, I think it was. And he did come with that. Obviously, in our little retro figure here, we got an extra head and a pair of fists. The extra head that we got, this is what it looks like. I'm just going to show that right now. You see that? And it's almost the same, just a little bit angrier, I guess. But it's almost still neutral, but it does have the dark highlights both on the forehead and below the eyes. So he's still sporting the blue highlights in the hair, so that's pretty cool. And of course we get the fists. Like I said, he came with a pair of fists, so that's pretty cool. But there's our three Nightcrawlers, Toy Biz on the left, and the first Hasbro version on our right. Here we have Nightcrawler with probably his best friend on the X-Men, Logan, a.k.a. Wolverine. Next, we have another dear friend of Kurt's. We have Aurora Monroe, a.k.a. Storm. Something I need to let you guys know. When I switched out Wolverine for Storm, for some inexplicable reason, the X on her right side just popped out. So they are separate. In fact, they're what's keeping her cape in place. Just figured you'd want to know. Next up, we've got his sister, Anna Marie, otherwise known as Rogue. And we know Rogue isn't going to be too far away from hubby. Talking about Remy LeBeau, otherwise known as Gambit. Bringing up the rear from Wave 1 of his teammates, we have got Lucas Bishop. And here's a group shot of all the figures from this wave. Wave 2 of X-Men 97. From our left to our right, we have got the Executioner. Then we have Magneto as Professor Lencher. Then, of course, after Nightcrawler, we have Jean Grey, Scott Summers, a.k.a. Cyclops, and Madeline Pryor, the Goblin Queen. And if you've been following this series of reviews, you knew already I wasn't going to get out of here without posing the sixth figure from Wave 1, and that's the villainous Magneto, as always. Been end-capping all of the reviews with him in some type of scene with the subject in question for that review, and no different today. So, and if you look carefully, there's a part of an aftermarket Banff Effect that I have. The other half is still on display, so I figured I may as well do this. I will attempt to get something that's a little bit more definitive of a Banff Effect, but for right now, 'tis enough, 'twill serve. As far as my final thoughts on Nightcrawler for this wave two of X-Men 97, the upcoming show on Disney Plus by Marvel Animation, courtesy of Marvel Legends. See how I got all that in there? The figure is even nicer than the previous release, which is a Hasbro release, simply because we've got the pinless joints. Basically, everything else is essentially the same. We got different head sculpts. The figure itself is an upgrade. Of course, the previous figure we got, we received more accessories. We had two sets of extra hands and a cutlass sword that came with it, as well as different head sculpts. We didn't get that this time. We just got one head sculpt and one pair of hands, no weapons. And of course, we all know that the tail is not bendy wire. It wasn't bendy wire the first go round. And it isn't this go round. They basically meaning Hasbro, just repeated what we got and made some subtle changes. And well, not so subtle when you talk about the new legs and the new arms. So there is that. I'm happy with the figure. It is the sixth one in this line and the 12th overall for X-Men 97. Will we get any more? Well, we'll see the show. They're going to have other characters, so there's always hope that we're going to get another wave. That we can always hope for that. So, you know, keeping the fingers crossed, they're pretty good. What do you guys think about the wave, both waves in general? You know, they are animated or cartoon-based, so that might not sit well with some, because when it comes to the head sculpts, you can, you know, for the most part, clearly see that they are designed to emulate the animated version of the character. That, like I said, that may not sit well with some people. A lot of detail goes, you know, undone simply because that's how the cartoon / animated version would appear. So it is what it is. We knew that going in. So I'm not going to hold Hasbro on that. They're doing what they can to make it, you know, to mimic the cartoon. So yeah, it's all good like that. What else would be all good is if you guys go down below and let me know if you think it's all good or not, or anything else. You know what I'm saying? What you want to talk about? Give a thumbs up to the video. Subscribe to the channel. Share the video. I need to start saying that more often. Share the video so that maybe someone else will, you know, take in this content and they'll make a decision for themselves if they want to follow or not. And speaking of following, you can follow me to see if I upload any other videos by hitting that bell, that notification bell down below as well. And you'll be notified the next time I upload another video. X-Men 97, Disney Plus, Marvel Animation, Marvel Legends. The ruckus. We got through it, y'all. That's how it got done.